let's talk to Gary. This is Gary? Yeah.
Always a pleasure to see an officer of the law. I mean, officers.
He turns towards Kim. Should we try this stuff again? My mug, why would you think that? It seemed as if you were calling to it longingly when you cried, Yellow Man. No, that's not... Why would I be calling to a broken mug? Alright, I believe you. You look like the kind of a man who knows it's a crime to lie to an officer. He threw it away. Yeah, he said that. Maybe if we say we're gonna find him, he'll come up with more info, right? You're gonna find me, are you? I am. For 250 real, the maximum. Oh god, 250? How am I gonna pay that? He looks at the slip of yellow copy paper, then gets a hold of himself. Okay, I'll work harder. I'll pay it off, I promise. Logic says this is a considerable expense to him. 1 month's wage, most likely. And I'll never do it again. I don't know what got into me, really. Work has been stressful lately. Damn Koshko's price, dumping us out of competition. What did you do, Gary? Morell says. Nothing, nothing. Just answering some questions. Helping out the law. Or lucky racist. Will you grant us 3 wishes, Gary? Hey, man, he blushes. All I meant was that there are not many Solites around here. I'm just stating a fact. The lieutenant is a native of Revachol. Oh, yes, of course he is. I was just speaking about his connections. He flashes an impenetrable smile. Let's change the subject, okay? Rhetoric says, sounds like some conspiracy topic. You might be able to discuss it with him when the lieutenant isn't here, if you can remember it. Return without the lieutenant for this? Savoir Faire says. Your balance organ thinks it's a waste of time. Besides, this guy's gonna be gone. Your gut feeling tells you it'd be interesting. Yeah, we're not gonna be able to talk to him again once we leave here. Unless I just wait around an hour. Talking to people. Maybe. I think at 11 he'll leave. So I'm going to try this again. But I can't, unless I put a skill point into composure. I think I can do that. Wait a second. Yeah, that's done. Let's look at this. Eight-eyed Territorian tie. A slender bolo tie held together by an antique clasp in the shape of a bird skull. The skull features 8 cavities for eyes. It's disturbing, but you can't look away. Okay, so I get +1 Inland Empire for octuple vision and +1 Volition for cryptid's protection. This really helps with drama. Let's see, drama, Inland Empire, and Volition, because I'm going to go into this anyway. Drama is now 7, effectively, from the items. And what are the other two things? Inland Empire, plus 1. Could use another in that. Hunches and gut feelings. Conversations with inanimate things. Void of imagination, otherwise. What was the other thing? Was it volition? Yes. That's 3. Yeah, maybe drama's 5 without that, so maybe I'm better off putting that on. And I guess maybe I leveled up already. Otherwise, I need to put it into what? Court? Into what?
Always a pleasure to officers.
Composure. My composure is very low. Yeah, I can't level up. I must have done so already. Never mind. If I had an extra skill point, yeah, I could do it. But apparently I don't. Unless I wait around till when Kim leaves. Let's talk to these people, though. Horse-faced woman. The woman in the RCM patrol officer's uniform winces as she notices you.
I would really prefer not to talk to you right now.
As Lieutenant Kitsuragi explained, authority says, a patrol officer is the lowest rank in the RCM below a lieutenant and sergeant. Hold on, you're a patrol officer of the RCM?
Yes, I am.
She nods. I'm a cop, too.
I know.
He's the real deal. He has a badge.
Rhetoric says, it's hard to tell whether he's sarcastic or sincere, but if you had to guess, you would say the lieutenant is being sarcastic. I'm on a murder investigation. Are you the cavalry?
I'm definitely not the cavalry.
Is everything all right? Why don't you want to talk to me?
I don't know. I mean, why would I want to talk to you?
She's still avoiding your gaze. Have I wronged you? I've done that to a lot of people.
No, you haven't wronged me. It's okay.
She shakes her head and breathes out. Empathy says something changes in her. It's pity. Pity comes over her.
Okay, fine. Let's talk. What did you want?
Rhetoric says, what does one talk about with a fellow officer? So what precinct are you from? What precinct? Esprit de Corps says, am I from? God, he doesn't know. Oh, is she from my precinct? The man with the sunglasses says, deranged lunatic. The sunglass-wearing man pushes through his teeth. Who's that? This guy? One of these people? Conceptualization says you're getting an intellectually unsatisfying vibe from this conversation. Maybe you're doing something wrong? You have a blue uniform and mine is black. What does this mean? She seems confused for a moment. It means I'm a patrol officer, sir. I bet you liked that, didn't you? Let's be honest, that was some first-rate karaoke. Okay. Yes, that was pretty good. The man with the sunglasses says, what? No. He shakes his head stubbornly. There are universal standards of good out there, and that was just complete crap. Jean, she quietly interjects, giving you a compassionate side glance. He's not right. Treat him like you treat McCoy's little brother. Who's McCoy? Oh. Encyclopedia says, Lieutenant Double Yefrentor John Archetype McCoy's younger brother, Lance McCoy, though a man of 32 years, will mentally never surpass a 6-year-old. Hey, I'm standing right here. The man says, yes, and I'm wondering why. Don't you have a case to solve? Horse-faced woman says, yes, did you want something from me? You're the police, right? Cool, so am I. She looks around. I don't know what to say. Don't say anything, Judith, he says. Wait, is he police? Me? No, I'm just a man with sunglasses. I like wearing sunglasses inside. Sunglasses and a wig. Logic says, okay. What are you, the police, doing here? I'm just looking out for... Empathy says, you? No one, the man looks at her. I'm just a man with the sunglasses and you are... A policewoman. Yes. Her voice is quiet. A policewoman who just wants to do her job, that's all. She says quietly and looks away. Well, I guess they're checking up on us. Is this the crazy guy?
You look like shit.
Your ruffled face reflects from the man's sunglasses.
And I don't mean that as a metaphor.
You look like bleep.
Wow. You seem stable and in control. Allow me to say, alcohol really seems to have had a positive effect on you.
Thanks.
Now, what do you want?
His tone is impatient. Visual calculus says there's something about this guy that matches with a face in your head. A similar but different face. Drama says he might be wearing a disguise. Kim, who is this guy? He shakes his head. I'm not getting involved in this. Esprit de Corps says, it's not my style, he thinks, glancing at the man in sunglasses. And the woman beside him. Ooh, boy, they're mad at him. No wonder. He just doesn't recognize them. Cool shades. Are you wearing a disguise? Yes. It's a hobby of mine. He looks at you inquisitively. Rhetoric says, as if waiting for some kind of reaction or response, something to click. It's not happening, though. Who is this guy? Yeah, he's somebody we should know. I got a +1 for calling my station. Is he my partner? Wait, what's his name? Partner's name was Jean, wasn't it? I can't go any further. Does she call him John? Or Jean? Let's try to figure it out. Success. You know what it is. It's like the two of you know each other. Just ask him. Tell me the truth. Do you know me from somewhere? Oh, I definitely know you from somewhere. Esprit de Corps says another life. From where? From another life? Yes, from another life. A different life. Maybe the life of a police officer belonging to the ranks of the... He pauses. To what station do you think you would belong in this alternate and totally fictional reality? 41st? Okay, okay, the man sounds genuinely excited. That's plausible. That's entirely plausible. Now we're really getting somewhere. He gives you a long, meaningful look and adds, somewhere good. Let's talk more about that hypothetical station 41 you mentioned. Oh, the hypothetical 41. Yeah, let's fantasize about that. He blinks aggressively. I'm not busy. You're not busy. Let's just play around. So what would our relationship be in this alternate universe? Let's be crazy. Let's say you and I are partners. How's that for a thought experiment? Kim's cooler than you. I'm sure he's flattered, but Kim is not part of this thought experiment. In this one, we're partners. The lieutenant is silent. Like partners in crime, or... No! He exclaims excitedly. 'Cause in this thought experiment, we are police officers. In a police station, we don't do crimes. We're not crime bros. Come on, stop it, she says quietly. Is she talking to him or me? Do you have a crime to solve? Oh, no, no, no. You see, I enjoy watching other, better cops solve crimes, and let me tell you, it's been quite a privilege seeing you work. This isn't helping, she says, shaking her head and looking at the man with sunglasses disapprovingly. Who else are in our imaginary police station? You're not going to believe this, but... The man pauses for dramatic effect. Police officers. Yes, sir, solving crimes, locking up bad guys, and get this, and not getting a drink on at 2 o'clock. Just some regular boring MFs in suits and uniforms, nothing spectacularly extravagant like you, the far-out son of Lung. Who is the far-out son of Lung? Oh, it's you. You eccentric genius. He winks at you sarcastically. I mean, with your unorthodox approach to police work, it has to be you. Want to tell me more about him? Or her? Not even a little bit. It's an urban myth, the lieutenant says quietly, about an officer who is so far undercover he can't remember who he is. As I said, just an urban myth. You're not the son of Lung. Empathy says he's trying to protect you from further rough handling dashed out by the sunglassed man. Conceptualization says, okay, yes, you get the joke. Leave it at that. I can't imagine it anymore. Neither can I, partner. Neither can I. His gray eyes suddenly flash above the glass frames. They feel sad. Empathy says, it's a mere second, but it feels like you saw something. A gram of compassion in that sadness. Got some questions for you. I'm a cop. About what? You don't look like a cop. He inspects you. You know what you look like? I don't know. You tell me. I don't know. He taps on his forehead, thinking, a sad sack of crap next to someone far more proficient. He didn't answer your question, Thority says. Now will you answer some questions for me? No, he says calmly. They keep staring at you. Why not? 'Cause it's not my job. Why don't you go and do yours and solve this damn hanging? If you don't want to answer questions, maybe you want to hear me say things? Actually, I don't want to hear you say things. Come on, Jean. Yeah, it's his name. He's our partner. And did he sound like that over the radio? Okay, say things. He adopts a lighter tone. I want to hear you say things. Authority says, hear that? He wants you to say things. Say one. Reaction speed says, suddenly, up out of nowhere, case-related things start popping up in your head. I have a little problem. The person who was hanged is still hanging there. I still haven't taken him down. You're not crapping me, Mullen. I can smell it all the way here. The whole town stinks. We're getting to it, Kim says. There have been complications. Wait, can you maybe help? I would love to, but I'm busy screwing off and not cramping your style. And that might cramp it, you see, helping you. Hey, why am I even telling you these things? I don't know. Why are you? He gives you an odd look. Logic says, it's like you felt it would be intellectually stimulating. And, oh, 9+, we got. And would lead somewhere. A custom, even? Strange. Oh my god, there's more. He looks at you in disbelief. You want something more. What is it? Let's talk about the hanged man again. Okay, why not? Let's do the whole thing over again. We're not wasting time. There is no time. Okay, I'm doing this investigation. A man is hanged. So, do you know who hanged him? Not yet. Yeah, I can see that. Alright, then see you around. Watch out for yourself, loser. Wonderful. A speed of course says, okay, the man with the sunglasses in his hypothetical station 41. Weird, right? I know, super weird. There's something we're missing here, something you can't put our finger on. You know what? Just ask him. I know it sounds crazy, and you'll probably get laughed at, but still. I was thinking the same thing. I should just ask him if we're from the same station. Yes, just cross it off the list. It's probably not true, though. Oh, now I can level up. Wait a second. I want to put something into composure. Because it's very low, and we can talk to this guy again. Before he leaves. I'll be right back. I gotta talk to this guy. Just chill out, Sunglass Man.
Always a pleasure to see an officer of the law. I mean, officers.
Okay. Try again. 42%. Why is he shifting around like that? Analyze Gary's composure. Damn it. Can't make head or tail of this sound. Honestly, his rude stares will stop. Whatever. The missing insect's case. Alright. Find out the real reason why the trap was empty. Local kids might know. Ask Kuno about the empty trap and take a look around the yard. Alright, let's talk to him again.
Again. I can't believe this shit.
He shakes his head, looking like he really is having trouble believing this shit. Look, I just have to ask, are we from the same police station? I'm going to say no, just to see what you'll say to that. What do you say? We are. He's our partner, and she's a patrol person. I don't know why she's with him, actually. Okay? Okay? Jean, he said okay. Give it a rest. Esprit de Corps says, okay, I was clearly wrong. He's a firefighter, male nurse, animal control agent. Something of that kind. Not a cop. Go on with your cop work. Don't let me stop you again. He's our partner. Does she have anything else to say?
Yes. What is it?
Are you with him? Of course I'm with him. She seems startled by her own tone. Why do you ask? He's a jerk. You're a jerk, he pauses. You know what? Maybe we're both jerks. Please, she looks at you, then him, then you again. Let's not turn this into another exchange, okay? Another exchange. When did we last have an exchange? Look, something is really bugging me. Are we or are we not from the same police station? God damn it, you leave her alone. The man with the sunglasses snaps at you. Keep your weird crap to yourself and be professional for once. Can I actually help you with something? She looks at you apologetically. Yeah, answer the question. Esprit de Corps says, yes, of course, preposterous. I mean, you would remember if they were, right? Who forgets their squad mates? That's not possible. With Harry it is. He's forgotten everything. Whatever. I don't mean to sound paranoid or anything, but... anyone else we can talk to besides these people? It's about money, alright. No, I never... you can't get in there, right? What about the fence? We can talk to it or something? Oh. You see a set of tire tracks in the brown slush that covers the plaza mosaic. Why am I looking at this? Cop habit. You look at everything. Logic says this isn't case-related, you think. Why? What kind of vehicle drove through here? Hard to say, Perception says. Reconstruct the movement. Success. The tire tracks were left here by an unknown event that took place some days ago. It's a message written in the language of burnt rubber. Could I have always looked at this? I just never noticed. Some of that rubber stuck to the tiles right in front of the whirling rags. This is point A. The driver started here. And then accelerated straight into the fence, left a hole big enough for the Franco-Nigerian cavalry, according to the cafeteria manager. What happened next? The driver proceeded to back out of the yard, barely stopping before hitting the adjacent building. Before heading south. Must have been in a hurry. This is where I started off with my motor carriage, before sinking it in the sea. Kim says, no wonder the cafeteria manager seemed frustrated when he was giving us directions to the yard. Well, he gestures toward the gaping hole in the fence, you did provide us with a very convenient access point to the crime scene. Alright, I think I got it. How do I get in there, you know? I guess we talked to Kuno again about the bugs. Kind of tired of talking to Kuno, but at least it's been a while.
Kuno's like Kuno's dad! Kuno doesn't give a fuck about anything!
Okay. Well, Kuno. We can buy that if you wanted to. You wouldn't happen to know anything about any missing locusts? No, Kuno doesn't give a crap about bugs. Redrick says, so he knows locusts or bugs. Oh my god, the little one seems distraught. I told you that crap is lame. Shut up, C. Now they're going to take you to lame prison. Empathy says she sounds like she's about to cry out of disappointment at Kuno's newfound lameness. Lame why? Because he knows that locusts are bugs? Oh, now hold on. No one is lame here. Just tell me what happened. Deny everything, Kuno. You need a lawyer up. Kuno's not going to say anything without his lawyer present. Conceptualization says lame. That rings some bells. Could this be connected to Night City, aka the City of Rage? Physical instrument says, yeah, that's pretty lame. Sounds like art. Kuno, is this about Rage City? I have no idea what Rage City is. Oh god, Kuno, no! The little one behind the fence takes her hat off. It's gonna happen now. They're gonna make you lame. Stop it, see? No one's gonna make anyone lame. Kuno's got this under control. Reaction speed says, there's definitely something going on here. You should check out Kuno's shack. The one with the pig's head. Okay. Well, I've been there before. I don't care that Kuno doesn't care. How about that? Oh, this. Can I go in there? From no. I wonder who is in there. Like, we really shouldn't be able to see in there, but I can. Alright, let's look in the shack. We'll find something new. It's crawling with locusts in here. Perception, hearing, says all around you the hisses and chirps of locusts fill the musky air. The earthen floor of the shack has been shaped into mounds of mud dotted with little holes for windows. Conceptualization says, like skyscrapers, spires of dirt and sand rising, accommodations for their insectoid inhabitants. Well, detective, appears you've solved the case. The lieutenant looks around, writes something in his notebook, and turns to you. Of the locusts. For the missing locust case, which is a subcase of the imaginary insect case. So at least that's going well. Stop being so sarcastic, Kim. Oh, I'm not being sarcastic at all. We're making real progress here. Redrick says, when someone says they're not being sarcastic, it's usually a good sign that they're being very sarcastic. You think the Insulinian phasmid is nearby? If anything, the presence of the locust points to the opposite. The phasmid did not take the bait from the traps. It was Kuno. The phasmid doesn't exist. He shrugs, but what do I know? Logic says, use your powers of deduction. You knew the magic bug was nowhere near here. The phasmid is impairing your judgment. We should talk to Kuno about this. Get him to stop. I'll let you handle the Kuno side of things. You're doing just fine. Alright. Confront Kuno about the locusts. Right. Kuno doesn't care. That's gonna be the answer there. But you never know, maybe we'll get something out of it.